Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Streamlit part 10, where we're going to take a look at navigating between pages in Streamlit. Streamlit was not a native multi-page application framework, but they've added it as it's gone along. So it's a work in progress still. First, I want to take a look at this README where I just did the project structure where we do app pages. And then I'm going to show you two different ways that we can use this folder structure and have our page files and app at the top level. So if we go into app and run it using Streamlit run app and go to the file, you can see how all these pages are automatically added to the sidebar as pages without doing anything. Now you can use it this way, or the other way I'll show you is by defining the pages and making it more customizable. To implement the page definitions method, you actually need to change the name of the pages folder because that is recognized by Streamlit. So if you go in there and just rename this to app pages, then we won't have that conflict. If you do keep it as pages, it will show up as a conflict in the terminal. First, we want to define these pages for this app. Here's how you define a navigation page. You first want to generate a list of all the pages that you want to implement. And then after doing that, you want to do pg equals st.navigate and then pass it the list of pages. And then you define the position and if it's expanded. Finally, you do pg run to rerun the page upon each click. Now, if we reload the page, you can now see all the different pages. After completing the app.py file, we'll move to the intro file within the app pages directory. Here, we'll just give it a title and then add in what we want to be in our home page. So something like that. So navigate between pages was already done in the app.py file. This is how you do the navigate between pages, but we can just have a section for it as well where we can add some code for what we did. Next, we have page links. Page links are used to change between either internal or external pages. You can do this by either defining the path to the page with st.pagelink and then the directory path, or defining a URL to the page or external link you want to use. If you define to an external link, it will open in a new tab as well. So we can send it to intro or vizstreamlit. Finally, we have the switch page method. Switch page method is used to programmatically switch between pages. You can add more conditions to when this button could be clicked or would trigger a switch page. I just did a simple button, but it kind of just like decouples the switching page from the actual button, which can be useful in some control flows or execution flows. The button still works, but you could add in other conditions to make it more dynamic. So that is it for part 10. Navigation between pages or navigation pages. Up next, we have, let's take a look, execution flow. So maybe we'll throw in some navigate pages in the execution flow. In execution flow, we'll take a look at dialogues, buttons, obviously, fragments, reruns, and stops. We also will dabble in a little bit of forms. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.